Good evening everyone. So today we'll be starting our webinar about the simplifying the personal finance at the time of the crisis. So let's begin with it without wasting much time. My name is Sanchay Saksali and I'm a certified financial planner from Invest Teacher, and we are in this webinar with association with investing.com. So we'll begin. Today we'll be covering about this webinar about how we can manage the money at the time of the crisis, what will be the survival strategy to maintain the status quo. Along with that, we'll be covering what the income generating activities, what are the different types of income generating activities are available, so that the time of the survival and the time of the COVID-19 can be passed out. Along with that, we'll be sharing some of the goal planning strategies, and last but not the least, how you can manage or balance your assets and debts if they are in the negative zone or you have been paying high debts. So let's begin with our webinar with an introduction. We all know, but before that, there is a very important quote. It's not your salary that makes you rich, it's your spending habits, by Charles Azaf. So this is the system we need to adopt at the time of the crisis, even at the time of the beginning or before the crisis also, and for the lifetime ahead. So let's begin with the introduction part. As you all know that the entire world market is falling like a knife due to coronavirus impact. As an Indian investors, what strategies we need to follow to reduce our portfolio losses? This webinar is mainly focusing on these things, what strategies a person or an individual can follow to avoid their portfolio losses or their investment losses or their panic strategy. Besides this thing, as it is an interactive session, so we'll be having a discussion at the end of the webinar. So you guys get on ready with your questions. Before that, let's move ahead. What are the main thing? As you all know, in every 10 years or even after 15 years, there is a big crisis. So this coronavirus is also no exception. So this is a story of a sock with a rice. As you all know that in 1992, Hershel Mehta scam, which unleashed the entire blood in the Wall Street. And then moving ahead with the Ketan Parikh scam, which also breaks down in the year 2001 and 2002, and then moving ahead with the one of the biggest fall in the American crisis, it leads to the subprime crisis of a fall in the Lehman Brothers, which led to the entire global economic recession. Even more than that, in on 2011 and 12, there is again a crisis by the sovereign debt crisis faced by the Greece, and then on in year 2016, demonetization by Modi government, which leads to the fall in the market from the top. And this time, plunge in the crude oil crisis, the spread of coronavirus, the war between the US and China trade deals, and a lot of chaos over the world economy, leading to the instability in the market. So these crises and these shocks and these noises are just as many as in the past happens. So these are not the new, but after every crisis or after every shocks, there is a rise. So that's why these all story tells us, after every shock there will be a rise. So without being much worrying about what will happen in the next time and how this shocks will go on ahead, what will be there tomorrow, worrying about these things, look for what you have been getting right now and what opportunities are at present. So that's what's the basic story about the story of shocks within rice. Now, so as you all know, it's a shock. Currently at present is a shock. So what should we do if your investments are being impacted by the end COVID-19? So the first thing first and the foremost thing that one can do is plan wisely. Yes, if you guys are having your emergency funds for 6 months or 3 months, it's time to build liquidity. So you have to build liquidity for the expenses of up to 2 to 3 years. Better to plan it wisely, how much to spend it, how much to invest it. It's time to spend only on items which you need it. Try to avoid credit money, try to avoid credit card payments, because this time if you being fall into the prey of credit payments, you're gonna have to pay the huge interest rate in the coming months also. So better to try to avoid the credit money and spend only on items which you actually require. Third thing is buy local or items which are following the COVID-19 safety measures. Jaan hai to jahan hai. If there is a life for you, you have to live it very sustainably. Under otherwise, there is no use of spending that money over it. So better is focus on your health rather than spending money excessively on items which are not good for your health. So that's what the basic thing about the health. Now we move ahead with the investments. What happens to your investment? What should you do if your investments are being impacted by the COVID-19? The first and the foremost thing you can do is don't just fall prey into the news. It's a noise. There are lots of news coming every day and every hour and even every half an hour. In the news channel, you turn on and they are always saying it. Watch this news, the COVID-19 cases has rise. There is something is happening. These all are the noises. They are not going to give you anything except the panic or anything except the discussions. So better to avoid them. Time also. One more thing, discounts. I know there are lots of investments which are coming at attractive prices, but if everything is at discount, it doesn't mean that everything is for buy. So before buying any investment instrument, whether it's in stocks, in real estate, or gold, though the gold is rising, but it still is not at price that much. And even on the groceries items, even the shop clothes, lots of items are at discounted everywhere. So it's better to not buy all those items that are discounted, because if you don't have a cash to spend on your emergency funds, then how will you survive? So better to save cash and be a miser. This time, use the miserly skills, save as much and then spend. Further ahead, don't experiment with your investment categories. Yes, don't experiment by buying like, okay, I'm getting this stock in a very attractive way, I will buy it. Okay, this mutual fund schemes has fall down, their NAVs have fall down to 25 to 30%, it's time to buy or I should increase my SIP. Better than increasing your SIP, time to revisit your mutual fund portfolio, your investment portfolio, your insurance policies, your health care, everything. Also, your bonds, mutual funds, anything investments you have made out. Don't experiment with the new or the existing one. Try to rebalance it or consult it from an expert or a financial planner before making any decisions. And to increase your income in this time of the crisis, try to enhance your skills with the lockdown, learn new technologies about the internet and everything. Moving ahead with liquidate the liquidity. Yes, now you understand that real estates are hard to sell. So better to liquidate it if you are facing the cash crunch issues. Buy small assets only before spending too much. Yes, save before you spend. So better before spending any much too much on the expenses like buying items like clothes or a car, better to spend on items which you needed at present and save as much as you can. We'll be sharing out how much you can save in the coming slides about like how much percentage will we need to save at present in the crisis so that the crisis runs over or the survival strategies during the crisis can help you out. Third thing is, if income source is difficult but investments are there with you, then liquidate it with proper withdrawal planning strategy. Don't just panic and liquidate all your assets. Liquidate your assets in a proper manner with if you are investing in a mutual fund, try using SWP, systematic withdrawal plan, so that you will getting a regular way of income. If your source of income is getting stuck or if you are not getting any kind of idea about a second source of income, try to use your existing investment as a systematic withdrawal plan so that you will getting monthly income or a weekly income as per your strategies after being a proper consultation with an expert. Fourth thing, cover yourself. Yes, pay premium regularly towards your health, life and accidental damages. This time as it is, jahan hai to jahan hai. So if your health is good, you'll be better able to cover all your expenses. So hospital expenses will be increasing due to the high demand, your life and accidental. So the lots of people, there will be sudden lockdown which is happening. Even the COVID 19 measures have not come. There is no vaccine has come out. So in India, the government has already been planning on some lockdown strategy. So it's time to be very much cautious about your health, about your traveling part, about your lifestyle. So it's better to concern with them or pay their regular premium. Cover all your insurance coverages. It's a very good saying. Insurance are for emergencies, not your investment. So don't just fall for the unit plans or anything. Try to take up a health if you don't have a life insurance, then opt for a term plan or health insurance or accident insurance. If you have all these three insurance, you are being very much covered with your life. Second thing, try not to opt for loan moratorium as offered by the government. Yes, as you can see, the Indian government has already been given a 6 months, almost a 6 months. They have been previous 3 months and the coming 3 months in August have given a loan moratorium where you don't have to pay the interest, but for the 6 months. After that, you have to pay the interest. So you're gonna have to pay it either today or tomorrow with no discount. So better pay today to avoid any kind of haziness or any kind of imbalancing in your portfolio in the upcoming days or in the future after the crisis. So third thing, spend time with your family while learning new things or business idea or do some freelancing work, which helps you in building your second source of income. At this time, you can like think about what you can do about your investment if you are being infected by the COVID-19. Now, what will be the ahead of in COVID-19? Till now, I have discussed about what you can do, but what as an investor, as a stock trader, or as a new market interact, what things you can do with your behavior matters, as your behavior helps you in making a decision about your investments. So don't just fear, stay safe and have patience. I've already said it. So take decision after consulting from the qualified financial planner like us. One more important thing is volatility comes and goes. It is up to us what to learn and what to lose. Currently, as we can see, the market has recovered almost like 20-25% from their bottoms. So it's better not to be fall into the prey of volatility. The more the volatility, the higher will be the risk. So rather than risk, looking at like, okay, the stocks which I have seen that 40% down, it's like move at 200% or like 50% from the bottom. Rather than look at their business model before investing in any stock or any mutual fund schemes also, watch out their portfolio. Watch out their portfolio sizes, where they are investing their money, or if you don't have that much of time, consult with a professional before making any kind of an investment. Fifth thing, rebalance your portfolio if it is still leading more than 20%. Yes, if your portfolio is leading more than 25%, it's time for you to revisit your portfolio. Watch out like which stocks have fallen down, why it has fallen down, rather than just sell it off. Look out and study their crisis. There's always a one saying in the entire investment strategies and the behavior thing is, most people do the average down method, which leads them most of the time to losses. But the people who follow the pyramid strategies or averaging up strategies make the most of the money. So if you are buying lots of things at a discounted price, thinking about, okay, my price will come in near future or lucky, it will recover in that soon. Better going down for averaging. Look out why it has fallen down before making any more or much investments or averaging out that stock or that mutual fund schemes. Educate yourself as much as you can. As you can see, there is a lockdown going on or the more going ahead or might come ahead. So better to learn more about the markets or investment strategies or any new skills which can help you out in making better decisions or increase your income. Further, as you can see, there are a lot of people coming around due to the discounting markets, and markets have come at a very discounted price. Lots of people are coming to trade too much. Okay, just a second. I'm getting a Ram Nivas Agarwal. There's a lot of disturbance in the background. Can you please look at it? Okay, just a second. Okay, I hope there will be no less noises now onwards. Okay, so shall I move? Okay, now the voice has not been an issue anymore. The rest of the messages I have cut it down. So where we were? Okay, so here we are. Okay, as you can see, there are a lot of investors and new investors and are becoming traders right now due to the lot of discounting and the volatility in the market. It's time for you to not trade too much without knowledge, without learning. It's better to learn the trading before making any kind of investments or strategies or like putting money in any assets. Invest, or if you are being a long-term investors, don't look for short-term returns. If you are planning to invest for more than like 6 years, then look for stocks after the 6 years passes. Don't look for their short-term price movements. Don't look for like month investment. Okay, I've seen it like 10% rising, I should sell it. Don't look for that thing. So that is the most important thing, is don't trade too much. Invest only on quality, growth, longevity, and stocks which are available at a very good prices or at a discounted prices. Now here comes another part of what should you can do if to create your another secondary source of income. So as you can see, the lot of things has been switched out from the physical world to the online world. So it's time for you to learn digital marketing. If your businesses are more to the physical thing, try to make it a more digital marketing thing, or use marketing your products to digitalize your businesses. If your reach is to go to the more customers, try to develop a software or an app for an Android. Lots of people today are using mobile phones, so it's time for you to learn the skills of creating an app, so that if you have any idea about like any services you have come around, you can create an app and go for it. Another thing that most people have doing it, even in the research time we have seen it, there is a sudden rise of almost like 20-35% in increase in like stock and new demat accounts. Also people are going for the stock market trading, as it's easy to buy and sell any stock in the market. So better to learn more about it, enhance it as your skill and as a hobby. Third thing is website development. As I said, there are a lot of things as we coming into the technological world, internet of things. So better to learn more about the IT courses. It will help you out. It not only on enhancing your skills, it will also help you out in keeping you update with the latest trends and technologies. Further, if you are being an individual and you have gained a lot of experiences in any other field, like in acting or in like an engineering or anything, in like civil engineering, automobiles, anything, you can conduct session by sharing your experiences. Lots of people are coming up and by sharing their sessions online, so you can charge for your e-session and make money out of it. So it's time for you to conduct sessions and share your experiences, and so that it can help you out not in nurturing your skills, but also help you out in making or reaching your knowledge to others as well. So these are the measures, 5-6 strategies which you guys can follow and make the most money out of it. Now we are moving ahead with the goal planning part of the simplifying the personal finance strategies. As you all know that the earnings comes and go, but the time is to create an emergency fund. So try to create an emergency fund for around like 2 to 3 years. As you all know that the COVID-19 is a communicable kind of a disease, or it's like a transferable disease easily. So it's better to create an emergency fund for at least 2 to 3 years. It's not for 6 months now, it's time for you to create an emergency for 2 to 3 years, so that your current life status quo won't get impacted much, even after you were getting a very less income from your prime source of job. Second thing, consult the expert. As I told you earlier, if your portfolio is bleeding more than 20%, it's time for you to consult it and rebalance it. Third thing, payoff. Yes, lots of people are getting are paying their EMI either in the housing loan or either they are paying credit cards. As you all know, the housing loan interest rate have already come down. If your bank doesn't reduce your interest rate, it's time for you to refinance your housing loan or cut down your high interest payment by paying off all their debts if you have the money cut off the high interest payments cost and switch towards the low interest payment options. It will help you not only reduce your expenses, but it will also help you in increasing your some part of your income for you. So your expenses will getting reduced if you're not paying too much interest on your loan and you're getting a amount of money with in your hand. So that's all the goal planning strategies you can follow. Now we have come to the another point of managing and balancing the debts and assets. As you all know that the debts and assets are both are very vital things. So at the time of crisis, the most important thing one needs to do is they need to either create or switch to assets which can generate their income. As I already told, if you have existing investments in mutual fund schemes, try to opt, or if your SIP is already going, try to opt for SWP method. It will help you on generating a withdrawal plan with a very good strategy so that you can able to pay off your daily household expenses. Pay off your debts if you are paying a high interest rates, I've already told it. Build assets from extra surplus. Yes, this is the most important thing that the most people are currently doing it. They think that they have built up the emergency funds or they have the funds. So they are start spending their emergency funds into their investments. So better not investing all their emergency funds into investment. Try to build assets from the extra surplus which is left after your expenses and expenses, but yes, before saving. So before, first save and then spend it. I've already written 25%. Yes, this time you need to save at least 25% of your income into the savings part for the emergency funds, and then move ahead, pay off your expenses, and then move ahead for the investments parts into equities for the long term if you have funds, or into the mutual funds, SIPs and more. Fourth thing, change the habit of buying illiquid assets. Yes, as I told earlier, there's a huge discount going on and lots of new discounts will come. Government will offer lots of leverages, lots of advantages, benefits to the customers, either directly or indirectly. It's time for you to change the habit of buying illiquid assets. Don't try to fall into a prey of like property. Okay, this time the property has prices has reduced to 20% and now 10% has reduced, 30% discount. Don't look for that thing. You have already know the current property situation have already not giving you any income. So better not going for any illiquid assets. Try to offer assets which can give you better liquidity payoff. So try opt for bonds or FDs or bank fixed deposits or any kind of instruments which can give you fixed income. Sixth thing is live present life healthy and stress free and don't worry about the future. So that is the most important thing one needs to follow on. I hope I'll be able to answer and simplify the personal finance strategies if you guys have it. So that's all for today. And if you guys want any other questions, you can discuss it on our Facebook group channel. I hope I'll be able to answer all your questions. And thank you so much for giving your precious time. And I hope you guys have learned something new today as well. Thank you guys. Have a great day ahead.